That video game that the kids in your life play is now one of the biggest game companies on Earth. Bethesda is now officially part of the Xbox family, and they brought presents for Game Pass subscribers. And I've got some reactions to The Falcon and the Winter Soldier. All that and the latest in everything cool today in The Rundown. Hey, welcome to the show. My name is Victor Lucas, and it's my privilege to be able to bring you the latest in video game, entertainment, and tech news. And we've got an awesome show for you today, and it's brought to you by our friends at The Gaming Stadium. This is Canada's leader in online esports tournament facilitation. They've got tournaments going on every weekend, and you don't want to miss out on the action. You can find out all about them at tgs.gg. All right, today's episode is dedicated to Lars Higgs, who said, Victor is a side-scrolling superhero reviewing god. That's somebody that's as excited about the new Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles game as I am. But if you're talking about huge games, you don't get much bigger than Roblox. The makers of Roblox, the gaming service that's probably the closest thing to the Oasis that we currently have, went public a couple of days ago and rang the opening bell at the New York Stock Exchange. The company's valued at more than $45 billion. The company had more than 32 million daily users at the end of 2020 and makes its money through the sale and purchase of Robux, the in-game currency which allows players to unlock digital items for use in the thousands of games that populate the service. Roblox describes itself as a metaverse where players can join and create communities across an assortment of interactive game types and worlds. Now, there is an unlimited amount of content for players to check out, but people can also build, share, and profit from the games that they design on the Roblox service. The content is pretty primitive and derivative currently. You can see copies of all kinds of intellectual property across the service, but this cash injection will certainly lead to more high-profile deals and partnerships for Roblox. It's the closest thing we have to a legit YouTube for games, and I gotta tell you, my kid absolutely loves Roblox. She really discovered it last year, and it's been an amazing and invaluable service for her to play and connect with friends that she can't really interact with currently in real life, unless everybody's distance. So almost every day my kid gets online and plays some Roblox with her friends, and it's been really cool to check it out. She's super excited about it. I've told her that there's some big things happening now for Roblox. And to put this valuation in perspective, Roblox is currently worth more than Electronic Arts, Unity, 2K, Ubisoft, Zynga, or Square Enix. It's massive. And of course, now all eyes are on Roblox to make good on all of the promises that they've made to their investors and to their partners and to the players out there. But this should be an exciting platform to watch. And I expect that a lot of people that are building these kind of simple games in Roblox are going to be future game developers, and we're going to be playing their stuff. And it's going to blow our minds that their career started in this video game. Now, speaking of small ideas growing into huge empires, Bethesda has officially become part of the Xbox family. In an online roundtable yesterday, Xbox officially welcomed Bethesda to the family, and executives from different divisions and studios all sat together and talked about what this means going forward and for the future. It was awesome to see Todd Howard up there with Pete Hines and Phil Spencer and Aaron Greenberg, and then there were all kinds of other people joining in on the conversation. This is clearly a massive deal. Many billions of dollars were exchanged to make this possible. And to celebrate, Xbox and Bethesda got together to basically remind us again that Game Pass is essentially irrefutable. The fruits of the Bethesda and Xbox deal start taking shape today, and Game Pass subscribers are getting access to a boatload of incredible Bethesda-published games, including Dishonored and Dishonored 2, classic Doom games, Doom Eternal, Fallout 4. You also have Fallout 76 if you want to check that one out. Prey is in there, Rage 2, and the amazing Wolfenstein games, especially New Order and Old Blood. And some of these games are going to have enhancements, of course, on Xbox Series S and X platform, so you might see some frame rate boosts and some HDR benefits as well. I know it's a bit weird and it's such a massive deal, it's kind of hard to wrap our minds around what this is going to mean for the entire video game industry going forward, because Bethesda has been so overtly multi-platform and agnostic in the past, and it feels strange for them to kind of change their whole business direction like this. But clearly we're going to see Bethesda developed content that's exclusive to Game Pass and exclusive to Xbox and PC. It's really Game Pass is the new platform at this point, isn't it? It's not really Xbox. It's not really PC. It's kind of that bridge, that Game Pass bridge. And I've said this before, but Xbox has been so aggressive with Game Pass. I can see Game Pass being offered on lots of different devices in the future. You know, they clearly are spending the billions of dollars to acquire all kinds of incredible game making talent. And since Game Pass is their new platform, you know, when you really conceptualize it, it's really this, non-hardware related idea is their new platform, very much the Netflix for games. I wouldn't be shocked to see this thing arrive on different platforms out there. Will it ever be Game Pass on PlayStation? Probably not. But, you know, there are always twists and turns in this business, and that's what keeps it so interesting. Something else that's very interesting is the MCU, and we don't have long to wait for the next big superhero show on Disney Plus. Now, I can't provide you with a review of the first episode of The Falcon and the Winter Soldier, but I can tell you that I have seen it, and I can share my social media impression, as well as what a few other reviewers are tweeting. First of all, I tweeted, "Watch the first episode of The Falcon and the Winter Soldier last night, and all I can say is that Disney Plus came at a perfect time for the MCU, loving these deeper dives into the Avengers stories. Also, appointment TV is a real thing again. You can certainly say that after WandaVision, right?" Now, Jermaine Lussier, who's from IO9, tweeted, "The Falcon and the Winter Soldier episode 1 is a solid setup for what I hope will be a very interesting series. The post-blip MCU is in full effect, and no one is okay. So far, it's a show of action and intrigue, but also trauma and regret. I think it's going to dig deeper than we expected." Our buddy Rob Keyes from Screen Rant said, "The first episode of The Falcon and the Winter Soldier has a 7 to 8 minute opening action sequence to kick things off. Then it becomes a refreshing reality check post-endgame of what life for real people is like in the MCU. Geeks of Color said, "The first episode of The Falcon and the Winter Soldier is another big step forward for the MCU. The action is very impressive and loses nothing in its transition to TV. The series' tone carries over from Captain America: The Winter Soldier and leaves you wanting more." And Perry Nemiroff from Collider says, "Loved how unique WandaVision was, but if you're eager for more MCU action, Falcon and the Winter Soldier delivers in episode 1. The visual possibilities when so focused on Falcon are already mighty exciting. Also eager to see the more grounded challenges teased grow as the season progresses." So I'm going to have some more thoughts on The Falcon and the Winter Soldier next week, but there you go. There's a little smattering of what's going on the socials right now. And I've got a couple quick things to tell you about. Beyond a Steel Sky, which I featured not too long ago in a VIX Basement episode, is an Apple Arcade and Steam game that's available right now. I interviewed the creators, Charles Cecil and Dave Gibbons, who collaborated on the game. Dave Gibbons is actually the artist behind Watchmen, which was really cool. It was a great interview. I'll link to it in the description below. Well, Beyond a Steel Sky is coming to the other platforms. Not a huge surprise. It's going to be available this year in both digital form and in retail form. And it's a pretty cool game. I haven't spent tons of time with it, but I did have fun when I was checking it out in my prep for the interview. Congrats to everybody at Microids, who's publishing it, and at Revolution Software, who have been working hard on this. This one. And finally, one last thing. These are visuals from a music video that a friend sent to me, and it really took my breath away. It's from an artist named Mixtape for the Milky Way, and the animation, which looks like it's all papercraft animation celebrating some of our favorite games, is from Eric Power. I'll leave a link to the video down below, but the music is really lovely, and these visuals are absolutely sensational. It's great stuff. All right, you guys, that's going to do it for the rundown today. Thank you so much for joining me on this journey. I'll be back again on Monday with a fresh episode for you. In the meantime, have yourselves a fantastic weekend. Thank you to all of our subscribers. Thank you to all of our EPN members. We'll see you soon. And until then, play forever.